Hi everyone, good evening. So I think I am the only Indian here, right? So it feels very good actually, because I think now I am the expert. Okay, so I am Manish Chitkara. So I am co-founder and CEO of Mo Magic. So I was by chance here in Taipei this week. So Charles invited me that let's speak something. So thanks for having me here. So I'm going to share a few insights. So wherever you have any questions, please interrupt me, ask me anything. Okay. Little bit about Mo Magic. So we started this company in 2011. So we are a mobile marketing company. So we help brands to reach out to users. And I think we have been lucky to partner with Mozilla when it launched in India. So we did a small trial. So I think it's a good opportunity that we got. So we also have an office in Taipei as well, where we have close to 30 people who are working on a platform for us. So why India is important? I think most of the people already know, but I just wanted to share some stats with you. So as of last year, close to 20% of the global mobile subscribers are based out of India. And the trends indicate that in 2020, the new user addition is going to be highest from the India geo only. Now, India has a good growth potential in terms of mobile subscriber because still the majority of people, they are not using the smartphones. So they are still using the feature phones. So they are still yet to come on to the mainstream, you can say. So it's very important for any mobile internet company from the entire world to, you know, have an eye on India, because that's an upcoming growth factor you can have there. So if you already know, so India is actually a very mixed culture. So it's like a, you can say, a combination of very small countries put together. So every state is a country in itself. So I wanted to show you this picture. This is a, in India, it's called a thali. It's a, you know, platter or a plate. So this is from a restaurant in New Delhi. So what they have tried to do is, if you see beneath the food, it's map of India. So what they are doing is that from each state, whatever is the popular food, they're keeping it, and it became very popular. It's from a New Delhi restaurant. So the idea here is that the culture is so varied. So even, so I am from the northern part of India. If I go to the southern part of India, for me, if I'm coming to Taipei or going there, not much difference is there. Okay. Because I can't understand their language. They can't understand my language. So it's so different variations are there. So I wanted to quickly share a research that actually was done by our company. So we wanted to understand the user behavior. So we selected three categories of users. One is the users who use news app more, and the social category, and the gaming category. So these are the three popular categories in India. So first we found that on an average, an Indian user has close to 50 applications on their phone. And this includes the pre-install applications as well. So India is like a very popular in terms of pre-installation, because one of the slides that was being shown that when Chrome growth started and UC browser growth went down. So the major factor of that was the year when the Chinese brands started picking up in India. And because Google forced them to have Chrome browser onto their phone. So that resulted in Chrome market share going up. And this UC browser was driving their users through the Indian brands, the Indian handset manufacturers. And their share went down. So that's how the UC browser share also went down. So that plays a big factor there. So male and female also had almost similar kind of applications based on this research. So this is what we found, that for a news category of users. So what we were trying to find, that if you are a news category of users, for example, if you are using, let's say, 4 or 5 news applications regularly, then what else you are using? So this is the results of that survey. So we found that the news category of user is installing more food and drink category of application as compared to other users. So you can see, I mean, food and drink, then health and fitness, then auto and vehicle. So this indicates that their inclination is towards these category of applications. Similarly, we did it for the social users. Social users in India, we found that they install dating applications maximum. So this is probably maybe common. it's fine. So this is, the results are more or less common. Of course, so we found that weather category is still popular in the social category of users. We couldn't find the real reason. Then the last one, it was really interesting to see what is the game category of users are doing. So here we were surprised to find that they were installing parenting kind of applications and the, you know, comics and the beauty. So eventually what we came to know that the children who play the games, they are actually using their parents' phones. So this is the common behavior in India. I don't know what is there in Taiwan or Greater China. So in India, the same phone is shared by different members of the family. So that's why users are also worried about their privacy. So it's very common to have one phone and multiple people will use it actually. So they want to make sure that, you know, the privacy is there, the history is cleared and stuff like that. Okay, so I'll share three characteristics of Indian mobile users, which is like the behavior. So these characteristics are not for the users like me actually. So because it's not the metro users, the tier one city users like New Delhi, Bangalore, Mumbai, I'm not talking about them. I'm talking about the masses here. Okay. So the first is that Indians love sachets. Sachets, I hope you all understand, like small packets. So they really love getting everything in small packets. And even if it is costing them more, still they prefer to buy in a small sachet. To some examples. So this is like a FMCG industry. So it's very common for members of the family to go outside to the neighboring shop, buy a shampoo chassis for like hair wash. So the cost is really low, like 10 cents, US dollar, 15 cents, it's so low. But the Indians have a habit of consuming everything in small sachets. So even if they, so if they do the calculation that if they buy a single bottle of shampoo, maybe it will cost them less as compared to buying this. So as the stats indicate, especially for shampoo, if you see in India, close to 95% of the sales of shampoo is done in a sachet, which is like in Indian rupees, maybe, you know, five rupees or less than that. So this is what is concerned with the mobile. So here you can see that Netflix and all the OTT players, when they entered India, they had a subscription of, 400 rupees, Indian rupees, 500. Then eventually they found that it's not working for them. So they launched a sachet pack of, you know, $1 in 1 week. So they said, just consume the content for 1 week, give us small money. So this is the indication of that. Now, this is the second one. This is where the Indians are very, very quick to adapt wherever they find something which is, you know, simple for them. It's entertaining, utility for them. They are very, very quick in that. So one example I want to give that is related to payments. So India launched a payment interface. The government launched it. It's called UPI. It's based on a mobile to mobile transfer. So this was launched in, I think, 2016, the kind of growth it has shown in a small period. So you'll be amazed by that. So this is a global players in terms of payments for P2B. Few players are there, five players are there. Every quarter. So within 3 years, India has reached like close to $50 billion of transactions happening from zero. So because it's very convenient for people, because everybody has a mobile number. They don't want to enter their credit card, debit card, mobile number, do the payment and it's done. So, I mean, this is one example. Another two examples are, you all know about TikTok, right? So it entered India less than 1 year back. So within 1 year, it became so viral that it has overcrossed the Facebook users in India. And second, Jio is a very popular phenomenon in India. So Jio has acquired close to 300 million users less than 3 years they launched. So wherever the Indian users find that it's good for them, they want to quickly change their way and just adapt to it. So the last one is, I think, where the you have already, it was covered in the first presentation as well. Firefox has also launched a light browser. So Indians are too much concerned about the storage, because the masses still have the phone which are not high-end phones. So they want to make sure that no application, no browser, anybody doesn't eat up their memory space. So this is already, like for Firefox, I think it's already done. So if you see all the players, whether it is Google or it is Uber or it is Facebook or it is Instagram or it is TikTok, everybody has launched their light version. So even Google has launched a Go version of everything, because they know that the Indian users want to make sure that everything is lightweight. Okay, I think nothing else from my side. So